About our sub modalities last week, people have all the resources they need to make the changes they want. People have all the resources. It is very often said that we have a warehouse of resources. I'm using metaphor here. We have a warehouse of resources within us. We've already got the powers within us. Yet very often we go into the warehouse with a pen lighter. And if you go into the warehouse with a pen light, what are you going to see?
Nothing.
So my promptuous suggestion is for you to go into the warehouse
with a torch, flashlight,
and put the floodlights on. Because if you're in the warehouse, even if you've got a torch, it's not bright enough, my friend. You need to go in and switch on the floodlights so that you can see everything within your mind. And it's all clear. And then you'll realize you can take the resource and use it. You can take the tool and use it. I once saw a guy giving a talk about Christianity, and he's building himself up. Very good talker, that's the Creflo Dollar Ministries. I'm into good talkers, so like I like to watch, even if the Christian speaker doesn't bother me. I'm not partial, but he's a good speaker. And very famous speaker, and a lot of money speaking. Some of these speakers have a lot of money, man. This guy's on private jet, etc. However, as he's building up, and why shouldn't he communicate as well? And I think building up, because now I'm going to tell you the secrets. And they say, what's the secret? The thinking, no one's going to tell you the secret. You only hear the word secret, you go, you already gave it here? You only sometimes get built up to something, and suddenly they go, whoop! And they go, is that it? Yeah. Is it already given here? You already gave it in there. God already gave you the powers. That's the secret, man. God already gave you the powers. Even before you knew it, he gave it you. Because you got it. He's already given it to you. You've got all the resources you need to make the changes you want. So you've already got it. Go in there, switch the floodlights on, make the change. I can talk to you now and I can say to you now, go in there, switch the floodlights on. There's ways and means of metaphorically doing it. And I'll give you a task later on today. Okay? Just get the floodlights, get yourself reconnected so you can switch the floodlights on and make the change. Brightness within us which needs tapping into. Every snowflake that falls from the sky is different. Did you know that? They all look the same, but they're different.
Size?
Its DNA is different. You put it under a microscope. Every single one that has fallen from the sky is different. So you have a unique, you were all very different. Every one of us has come and had birth in this and come to have a life in this world is different. We've got this uniqueness within us that gives us our greatness. My greatness is different to yours, but you're unique, and there's some parts of you that are unique. And that's what we're looking to tap into, the uniqueness. What internal questions do you ask yourself throughout the day? Are you constantly self-empowering yourself? So you need to examine, write down in your little diary as a task, what questions you're asking.
What?
Write down over the next couple of, before the next time I see you, what internal questions you're asking. What internal questions you are asking yourselves regularly throughout the day? That is internally, yeah? Why is it when one person looks at something and they find it really funny, and another person that looks at it see a serious side to it?
Just the difference.
They're different, yeah, and their interconnecting thought processes are slightly different. As I said to you before, when I go into my office, when I was working over in one of the offices over in the Black Country, and one of the managers I didn't like, I have to put a clown's nose on them and have a laugh, because even when they're sitting in front of me, I could see this big round thing on his nose.
Oh God.
Yeah. I say in my mind, I'd say, you're a joker. He'd be trying to tell me what to do, and I'd go, yeah, okay, I've got you, joker. I'd even play a little bit of circus music in the background as well when I see his face. And he's been serious and saying, Vika, this needs to be done like this, Vika, this needs to be done like that.
Oh, shit.
Yeah? That's how I manage my mind. Rather than if I look at it too seriously, I'm gonna have to do something. I'm going to have to leave my job. Leaving my job is a bad consequence to me, however, because if I leave my job, I've got a mortgage to pay. So I manage it in that, using that type of suggestive behaviour.
Internally and externally, if you'd have thought about it, right, you wouldn't have to leave.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Alright, mastering your mind means the quality of your internal communication determines the quality of your life. The quality of your internal communication determines the quality of your life. So what you say up there, one guy got shot down, American POW, his name's Jerry Coffey, he wrote a book. You know what POW is?
No.
Prisoner of War. Two of the guys that were shot down with him. One, now this is the treatment that they had to underwent. Shot in the room. Maybe as big as me, broad as me. Dark, kept in the dark for 8 years. Only allowed, regularly beaten, in shackles. Couldn't see daylight. When they come out, they get beaten, chucked back in. Little hole in the ground for them to do their shit. So it's like extreme yeah. Circumstances. One of the guys who was in there committed suicide and killed themselves. The other guy is in a psychotic ward till this today. Jerry Coffey wrote a book. And talked about how he managed his mind. What kind of questions he'd ask. He wrote a book. And he talked about his regular beating. He says, I would talk to himself, he prayed to him, he prayed to a God, if there was a God, you know, etc. Yeah, he remained sane, And he goes, that was one of the most empowering experiences of his life. And then we have another guy here that committed suicide, and we have another guy here that's in the psychotic ward. This guy here, that's a phenomenal experience. Well, isn't it? Yeah.
Well, it's because he was asking himself their questions.
That he didn't
go mad.
Yeah.
Being like the other one.
Yes.
Yeah, suicide. Yeah, the only way out.
Well, he couldn't take it anymore, so he committed suicide. How is it that Nelson Mandela was locked up for a quarter of a century? Came out and became a powerful leader. You see pictures of him now, smiling in while he's in prison. Come out as a powerful leader, Zed now obviously, but one of the more powerful leaders of this century. He led the country when he came out. Yeah. There's a lot of anti-apartheid back then, the doctor wasn't killed for his beliefs. Yeah. Because he asked the right questions, he could have been angry with the government and caused a coup. He actually came out and became president. Run for the country, very powerful man. And when one of the guys that interviewed him, he says, how did you deal with the bad treatment, and the way you was in prison for 25 years? You know what he said? What harsh treatment?